Welcome back to Superstition Mountain. In today's video, I want to address another student's questions, and this time they're about the differences in chipping and pitching and full swing shots. So I want to go through and discuss some of the differences and the technique and what we need to do to make these shots easy for ourselves. So let's talk first basics of full swing again. So in a full swing, our number one goal is to maximize compression on the ball and be able to control the direction. And so in order to do that, we're looking to create as much speed and force as we can. So what we're using is we're getting pressure and force into the ground, we're driving our body, and at impact, we're hitting the golf ball with our right arm lined up, the angle of our wrist laid back, and compressing that golf ball. Now, short game is basically the exact opposite. So, in a good golf swing, again, we compress into the ground. So if short game's the exact opposite, we're actually going to not compress into the ground. We're gonna come up out of the ground a little bit. And if you watch most good pitchers, when they hit a pitch shot, they're actually almost standing up through the ball. Why is that? Now the main reason is they're looking to unload all the angles that are created in the pitching motion. So we know that in the full swing, we're looking to have this lag tension or just the club lagging into the golf ball and creating a whipping effect. Well, here in the pitch shot, we're looking for control. We're looking to impart more spin with a smaller golf swing. So, for a pitch shot, there's really two basic motions. Motion number one would be kind of the long arms, no wrists. You'll see some guys on tour making a motion that looks like that, where they don't really use their wrists, and they hit it with just long arms. Now, what that creates is a fairly constant radius. I like that motion for short shots. And shots where you don't have to change trajectories much. So if all you're looking to do is just hit a 10-yard pitch on more or less a normal trajectory, it's a great motion to be able to have. It's a good stock motion. To be able to just hit that shot with not much wrists, the radius will stay the same. You'll see there's just a little bruising of the ground. You're not going to see much divot. That's one way to do it. Another way to do it is to have nice soft hands. So you're going to take the club back. You're going to have soft hands. The club will set slightly. And then you're going to use the way you pivot to unload the angles. So just like a typical amateur golfer, they unload the angles and look like there's no lag. This is a time when we actually want that. So, what do typical amateurs do? They stand up through the shot. So we're actually gonna allow ourselves to do a little of that. So we're gonna swing the club back. We're gonna let ourselves stand up a little bit and hit the shot. That's a good feel for unloading the golf club and getting it to line back up at impact. You wanna feel almost like you're just standing up a little bit. There we go, that one's gonna get close. The biggest differences in the pitching motion and the full swing is you do everything the opposite. We don't hold any of the angles. We actually want them all to unload. So instead of compressing into the ground, we want to come out of the ground. We want our swing to be kind of big and smooth, getting everything to line back up so we can have some touch.